Hey guys, welcome to the Fame Insider. The issue of protection fees in the Eastern Cape has unfortunately gone on to be a major problem that has left residents and business owners in the province with nowhere to turn to. And you guys, it now turns out that actually it is alleged that members of the SAPS, or some of them, are part of these extortion syndicates. So the problem started getting attention around 2022. However, as the years have gone by, it seems like these criminals are becoming more organized, and the residents and business owners in the Eastern Cape feel that, unfortunately, you know, our government, SAPS, is not doing enough to control this problem, because things are just getting worse, you guys. So it is said that in the province, in some areas, residents are being asked to pay a protection fee. Businesses are asked to pay anywhere from 500 to 200,000 rands a month, depending on the size of their business. And now they've even targeted some schools in Umtata, where teachers are required to pay up to 1,000 rands in fees, you guys. Yo. That is just crazy. Now, someone else who recently got affected by this problem is Nomvula hitmaker Nathi Mankayi, who recently had to cancel a show that was scheduled for the 5th of October in the Eastern Cape, as his promoter started getting phone calls from these criminals demanding a share of the proceeds from this show. Now, I mean, the crime in this country is crazy, you guys, and as the years go by, it seems like what you think is worse and cannot get any worse just gets even more and more bad, you guys. So he recently revealed that we were supposed to go to Mtata, and there was a group of people who wanted to be paid a protection fee. The promoter I had partnered with received phone calls from people saying they wanted money, a certain percentage from the show. I told the promoter it was better that we stopped planning the show. I don't want to lie, as much as Eastern Cape is home for me, if such things are going to happen, I'd rather not go home. Anyone else would have made the same decision. I'm not saying I won't go there forever. I'm just saying that I'll go when the time is right. Now, the scary thing, you guys, is that this problem is actually now moving on to other provinces. In Gauteng, there are actually some businesses that are actually affected by this. In Mpumalanga also, it has now started being a problem, and people have been voicing their concerns, you know, and they are saying that, is the government not planning a constructive plan or strategy to try and put a halt to this? Because at this point, it seems like these extortion syndicates will just be mushrooming, man. If they see that other criminals in other provinces are able to get away with this, what gives them reason to not also start their own protection fee business, or whatever they call it? But all in all, it is a major problem in South Africa. And unfortunately, you know, this does not seem to be a major priority to our government from what it looks like from the outside.